Well, hello everybody. Join me today for another nice little short fishing video, show you a little bit of what's going on. I'm at one of my favourite venues, Staunton Harold Reservoir, which is a Burton Mutual Club run water. You can buy day tickets online for it. It's a great place to come fishing. And what I'm trying to do is just catch a bit of everything. It's, you know, it's just into autumn, which is a great time of year to go fishing. We've had a very warm summer, which means all the water on these big venues is still really warm, which means the fish are feeding incredibly well, particularly roach. So you don't have to go far. I think one of the mistakes people make when they see a big water is, oh, I must cast as far as possible. It's not the case. You can enjoy your days fishing a lot more, in my opinion, by just trying to fish, bring something back, skimmers like that, nice big roach, perch, anything you like really. You know, I've caught bags 30, 40, 50 pound fishing like that. It's a great way to go fishing, and I think it gets ignored a lot of the time. So I'm just gonna show you how I go about it. It's really easy, one rod. My bait menu is super simple. So let's show you what I've brought. I've got half a pint of red and white maggots. I've got about a pint of casters, but I only get a few out at a time. I like to just pour a few casters in so they can brown off a little bit, and then add them as I'm going. And then of course I've got worms, and I've got some worms to the hook, and I've got some worms that I've chopped up there nicely as well. At this time of year, I think worms are an amazing addition. This ground bait is dead easy. This is literally a bag of sweet skimmer, an absolutely beautiful ground bait. You can use fish meal. I love fish meal ground baits. You could have used F1 green or anything like that, but sometimes I like to mix it up. I think if everybody's using that, I like this sort of bready ground bait, because I am literally going to try and just catch a fish for you every cast in. So I've been fishing for about 45 minutes. It's been a fish every bung. All I've been doing is just getting a little blob of worms on my fingers, putting that in my ground bait. And then not loads of casters. I like casters, but not loads, like half a dozen casters, something like that, a dozen casters, mixing it up a little bit. I've got a small window feeder on because I'm casting really regular. I expect the cast to be, look, just push that ground bait in nice like that. I expect the cast to be maximum 1 minute. So I don't want to have anything but a small feeder on. If I have a medium or a large feeder, then what's going to happen is I'm going to start plowing bait in, and I'm going to end up with way too much bait in my peg if I do that. So I've just let that hit the bottom. I reckon it's about 10 foot deep where I'm fishing, something like that. Maybe 9, 10 foot. And I'm holding the rod all the time. I'm not putting it on the rod rest. Look at that, look, indication there straight away. I can just watch what's going on all the time. And I feel like I can be in touch with the fishing now. I've got to be thinking about this all the time. What I don't want to be doing, look, bites there. God, it's just so many fish in my peg. Just getting stronger and stronger all the time today. So what I don't want to be doing when I'm fishing like this is I don't want to be piling bait in or piling the wrong baits in. That's the key to my day. I have to try to find out what's a good hook bait. That's a nice fish there. I'm trying to figure out what's a nice hook bait, and then I'm trying to focus my bait on that particular bait. So I think worm is working really well because there's a lot of fish there. I'm having to fish with a bait that effectively the fish aren't just going to strip off in 2 seconds. So I want the fish to be eating worms. Nice little skimmer there. Just to follow up that one that we started with, look. So these sort of nice 8 to 12 ounce fish, there's a lot of those in. There's a lot of nice roach in. So I'm looking, popping back. I've not put a net in today. You can put a net in at this water, but sometimes I just like to have a little fish and just be happy with what I'm catching, really. So that's why I'm focusing on the worm. So I'm just going to show you the whole process from start to finish. Got my worm there. I'm literally going to hook him like a maggot through the top. And then I'm going to decide what length of worm I want to fish. If I'm catching lots of little fish, I'm going to fish a little piece of worm. If I'm trying to hunt for a better fish, I might put a bigger piece of worm on. I could even put a whole worm on and try and see what comes back with that. So I'll tell you what we'll do just for the camera. We'll nip him off So it's almost like 3/4 of a worm. I haven't done that much today, but I always like to mix it up and see what's happening. And then, like I said before, a blob of worm, a few casters. Just get that worm right. You want like a thumbnail, almost like a bit of a taster really. And then just nipping that in the feeder and smudging it off. We've gone for a solid window feeder today. I love a cage window feeder as well, but when it's deep and rough, I want to try and keep all my fish on the bottom. And that's what a solid window feeder does. So it's hit the bottom, bring the rod round to the side. Lots of taps. I was expecting that really, to be honest, with that big worm. So one of the downsides of fishing a big worm is that often if there's lots of small fish there, they just pick it up and you don't actually hook them. But sometimes a big worm can actually be better because the fish are so ravenous, they just see it quick and they pick it out as a whole bait. But you don't know until you put it on. So I always like to mix it up and try throughout the day, and especially with those last fish being a couple of skimmers. If there's an odd pound skimmer in here, then that bigger bait could just get me a bite that a little bit quicker. Remember, I'm not gonna leave it in long. I'm only gonna leave it in a minute or so. Little tugs and pulls there all the time. Oh, another big tug. Liners, it's just crazy. That just goes to show when you have that bigger hook bait on, there's fish all around it, there's fish wanting there to eat it, but there we go, we've got one on. You're waiting, just waiting for that positive bite was the key there. I've got a big hook on. I'm gonna show you the rig and the terminal tackle now when I come in. So, what we got here then? Yeah, a hybrid. So that little hybrid has just demolished a worm the length of him. So you can see why you sometimes need to have, and he's got it right down. Look at that, he had that whole worm there. Crazy, crazy. That's why sometimes you need big bait. So let's look at the tackle. There is no place whatsoever for a tiny little hook. I've got a pre-tied 12, put it on my hand there, pre-tied 12 N20 to 014 AccuPower. And that, I've got about a metre and a half then of 028, that's right, 10 pound 028 line. Okay, look, so I've got a nice little loop-to-loop there. And then on my rig, I've got a swivel that runs behind two of those stops. Because this line is so thick, those stops don't slide very easily. So that's why I like to fish with that sort of line like that. And I've just put a little link on there myself with line to a 30 gram window feeder. Now, it's only a short length of line because I want to try and fish really braid direct. So I've got 010 braid on, absolute feeder braid, which it's just fantastic, straight off the spool, no pre-soaking, nothing like that. That's literally straight off the spool, fill my spool up on my 520 extremity. But what I really want to show you is my new rod. Love to talk about my new rod. This is an 11 foot Supera X carbon active range. So you can see here's the markings, 11 foot, that's 3.35 meters if you want to get specific in meters, 45 gram rating. And there it can take sort of 4 to 8 pound line. The beauty of these new rods is we were challenged with trying to do the best rods we could possibly do. So everything on it is the best that we can do. The strongest, thinnest blank. It's got a beautiful X-wrap carbon weave, which means we can make it slimmer and stronger, minimal guides, but it's an 11 foot rod. And that for me is the key when I'm fishing at this sort of distance. Don't want to be picking up a big 12 footer. I don't want to be struggling with a 10 footer trying to chuck it a heavy feeder 30 meters in this wind, but I want to still have a nice soft action. So I've got a nice bit of strength in this lower part of the rod, and then I've got a lovely soft action in the top. So when you're looking to do fishing like this, that 11 foot length is a real winner for me. That's a real popular length that I want to look for. And it's banging straight away with a fish on. Look, you can see it's rod bends all the way at the top when I'm winding my fish back. Look, I'm just winding. The fish isn't even playing at this time, but it just means I can wind those fish back any little kicks. I've still got a nice bend. but
that was a little fish.
But I've still got the strength here to whack my feeder out. I'm in a headwind today, and I reckon I could still easily cast this rod 45 meters. I mean, I'm hitting the clip at 30 meters, like bang, every time, nice and hard. So just goes to show how good that rod is and how strong that material is, even though to somebody picking it up, they're gonna think, wow, that's thin, light, crisp, that sort of nice action, really. So to be fair, it's an absolute joy to fish with, and that's the sort of thing that I'm looking for, because on this day today, if it was a match, I'm gonna be in the zone. And if it was a pleasure session like today, all I wanna be doing is enjoying myself. And you can see, I am in full power right now with loads of fish, having a great day. So there's no reason why you guys shouldn't get out there and have a go yourself.